Ciao, siamo arrivati alla lezione 30. Ce l'abbiamo fatta, we did it. So, as of now, we know pretty much everything we need to build sentences. Like, we know pronouns, we know adjectives, possessive, comparatives, we know the present tense, we know the present continuous, we know passato prossimo. So we have pretty much everything. But as you know, in every phrase, in every sentence, when you build it, you need prepositions. So that's the ingredient that is missing, and that's what we're going to learn today. Le preposizioni semplici. So in Italian, we have these 8 prepositions. Di, a, da, in, con, su, per, tra, or fra, fra is the same thing. So, di, a, da, in, con, su, per, tra, fra. Now, let's take a look at each of them singularly. So, di can express belonging. For instance, il libro di Luca, Luca's book. It can express origin. Francesco è di Milano. Francesco is from Milan. It can also express comparison, and we saw it just yesterday, remember? Antonio è più bello di Marco. Antonio is more beautiful than Marco. Now, in English, when it comes to material, it's very easy. For instance, if you need to say plastic fork, you don't need any preposition. But in Italian, we say forchetta di plastica. Same thing as for topics. When we're talking about, when we're discussing a topic, for instance, war movie in English doesn't need a preposition. But in Italian, we say film di guerra. The preposition a. A, it can express an indirect object. For instance, dire una frase a qualcuno, to say a sentence to somebody. Or it can express destination, andare a Napoli, to go to Naples. Also, when we are talking about in or at a place, we can also use a. Studio a Firenze, I study in Florence. Da, pretty important too. Da, it can mean since. For instance, da dicembre, since December. From, vengo da Roma, I am from Rome. Or to a place, domani vado da mio fratello. Tomorrow I'm going to my brother's. At a place, da me, at mine. Vieni da me o vengo io da te? Are you coming to mine or am I coming to yours? In, well, it's pretty similar to English. In a place, in Italia, in Italy. But this is different from English. When you say to a place, you can also use in. Vado in America. I'm going to America. In time, in questo istante. We use in questo istante to say this very moment. In can also express means. For instance, in macchina, in treno, by car, by train. Con is pretty easy, well, together, so sto con Bianca, I am with Bianca. Again, means, like before, con la bici, by bike, so sometimes it's in treno, in macchina, in barca, boat, by boat, sometimes it's con la bici, by bike, con la moto, by motorbike. So, okay, su is, generally speaking, is on. Sul tavolo is on the table. Now, this is sul because su plus il becomes sul, su il tavolo. Topic, un film su Garibaldi, a movie about Garibaldi. Per could mean through. Il treno passa per Verona. The train passes through Verona. For, questo regalo è per te. This present is for you. And destination, like l'autobus per Torino, the bus to Turin. And finally, tra or fra, as I said before, it's the same thing, è la stessa cosa. Now, it could mean between, scegliere tra o fra il bene e il male, to choose between good and evil. It can also mean among, il più grande tra tutti i pianeti, the biggest among all planets. Distance, tra 100 metri, in 100 meters. Time distance, tra un anno, in a year. Now, some of these, of course, you're gonna use all the time, and they're the ones that are easier to learn. You will memorize them right away. Some of them, you need to, you know, train your hearing, or just if you read a lot, then you will find them and you will learn them. Il corso di italiano in 30 giorni è finito. Io sono un po' triste perché non ci vediamo più, però sono anche felice perché sono sicuro che grazie a questo corso adesso sei in grado, you're capable, di parlare italiano e di comunicare, quindi ti aspetto in Italia, qui a Roma o in Italia, e buon divertimento, buon viaggio e in bocca al lupo, buona fortuna!